Hey guys, I'm going to show you a video of my steps when I do an interior cleaning on a car. My wife has the GTI today. She's determining if she might want to take over that car, like permanently. So I just have the CX-5 for today. So the first thing I always do is take out the floor mats if you want to do a proper job. Now, I have a dedicated vacuum for cars. It's one of our old vacuums. Looks like an Optima, lightweight, 12 amp, Eureka, something or other. This thing has got to be 10 years old at least. Still works like a champ. Really simple, a hose floor switch. It's not real good for a house, but it's killer for the car. So first, I'm going to go ahead and vacuum all the floors up. Next, I do like to part some of the pleats on the seats and get some of the crumbs out of the seats. What a strange little feature on this Mazda. I never seen this. It's a little VIN flap. That's pretty funny. You got your VIN stamped on the floor in there. Little hidden flap. Never seen that before. I got a couple interior detailers on hand. Just the stuff you can get in your normal stores, the Meguiars and the Mothers. I don't really order any of the specialty, really expensive interior cleaners and all the really popular stuff. This stuff works good enough for me here. So I have an oldish California duster I use for my interior. But if you just brush it on your dash, it's going to spread all the dust around. So I like to give it just a light mist. Not wet, just to get it a tiny bit damp so it'll pick up all that dust when you start dusting. And this dusting is my step before I do the final wipe downs and just kind of get anything left. So you may get a streak for a few seconds until it dries because it's a little bit damp. But this is better. It picks up the dust instead of just flinging it to another part of the car. You want to be very careful on your gauge plastics, specifically VWs are some of the worst, but the plastic can scratch easily. So don't just take a microfiber and just start rubbing these gauges at all. Use real light pressure so you don't scratch the plastic on your gauges there. This Mazda does look a lot clearer than the VW, maybe it's higher quality. Then after I've done my dusting of the dash and stuff, I do just do a light wipe down of some of the last remaining areas. Get it a little bit moist. Such as the sills can get kind of dirty. Get those nice and... This is actually glossy, but it isn't too sticky. It looks real good now, but as soon as you put your feet on it, just kind of screws it up. Really brings out the shine though, especially in your seat corners where you're kicking it, scuffing up the plastic. Just get it nice and clean here. I'm gonna go over the whole car. I'm not gonna make you watch that. One of the most overlooked places when cleaning your interior is your steering wheel. It's probably the dirtiest thing in your whole car. So you get your wet rag and you really get the dirt out of it. Especially in your hand holes over here. And when it hasn't been done in a while, the rag can be quite gray and dirty. And it also gives your steering wheel a stickier feel. When it's dirty, it's smooth and slippery. And it has like a rubbery, stickier feel when it's clean because you don't have all that dirt barrier on there. So that's just a basic interior cleaning. That's not a detail, a big fancy cleaning. That's just a quick once over in about 15 minutes. That's usually what I do, except maybe a couple times a year I might do a nice deep cleaning. I did wipe down the seats also. As usual with these type of videos, I never claim to be a professional detailer. I'd always be interested in hearing some different methods and different techniques to this interior cleaning, stuff that works for you. We can all help each other here. Give me some tips on how to do a better interior cleaning.